Well, she has won every music award that's worth winning, from the coveted Oscar to the Grammys, and celebrated by Rolling Stone magazine as one of the top 100 greatest singers of all time. Now, after almost 30 years since she signed her first record deal at the tender age of 23, Annie Lennox is no longer chained to a record contract. So, the former other half of the 80s sensation, the Eurythmics, is rounding out that chapter of her life with her first ever retrospective album. Annie Lennox talked to Erica Wood in London about the latest chapter in her extraordinary career.
At the age of 54, Annie Lennox is no less striking today than she was more than two decades ago, when Eurythmics were storming up the international charts. The difference is, now Annie is a free woman with a string of solo hits to her name, and no longer chained to a record label. Sweet dreams are
made of this. I've just run out of contract with the record company Sony, and I've been in a contract with a record company since I was about 23 years old, so it goes back a long, long way. And as it happens, like, coming out of this record contract, it seems like the appropriate time to put a collection out, to say, OK, this is this, and it's almost like rounding off the end of that chapter.
Hers is a songbook celebrated by Rolling Stone magazine's top 100 greatest singers of all time, a string of Brit, MTV and Grammy Awards, two Golden Globes and even an Oscar.
I'd like to thank Peter Jackson so much for inviting me to be part of this extraordinary project.
But for the humble Scott, the accolades barely feature on the radar. In fact, until recently, she says they were all packed away in boxes, covered in dust.
Any award I was ever given, I was always like, whoa, you know, wow, that's absolutely amazing. Thank you very much. But, you know, I don't put them on my mantelpiece in my house and go, here I am, you know, look at my awards. No. You have
come to choose. Your link with New Zealand is the Lord of the Rings, and that was what you got your Golden Globe and your Academy Award for.
Yeah, but I went to New Zealand before that and played in New Zealand, so, you know, I have been there and I know what New Zealand looks like and feels like, and it, before the Lord of the Rings and before New Zealand became, you know, invested with this extraordinary Tolkienish identity.
If her music identity had gone a little quiet lately, Annie Lennox herself certainly hadn't. Been a tireless spokesman for the likes of Amnesty International and Greenpeace, and even started her own charity, Sing, raising awareness for the HIV/AIDS virus.
I actually can hardly talk because I'm right here beside the reality of the HIV/AIDS situation, where you can buy coffins right off the shelf.
Why should people listen to you?
Oh, they don't have to listen to me at all. If they hear what I have to say and it touches a point for them and they feel connected to it and it inspires them, that's wonderful. Having visited other countries where people are just barely living on subsistence level, I suddenly realise, wow, I have so much and I'm just taking it for granted. You know, I want a purpose in my life and I need to have value in my life.
Well, if value in a music career is measured by sales, she certainly had those, selling nearly 80 million albums. Or if it's dictated by the number of times other artists have covered her songs, well, she's had that too.
I always find that very flattering if anybody, you know, wants to do a version of your song. Obviously, they like it.
Marilyn Manson, one of them.
And that was an interesting twist. I mean, Marilyn Manson doing Sweet Dreams in that way makes a lot of sense to me. So, you know, that was like, yeah, okay.
And like Marilyn Manson, the onstage persona has always been important, creating characters which are quite at odds with the real laid-back Annie.
If you're an artist, you need to be aware of all aspects of what you're doing. I mean, that's the creative part. That is being a performer and thinking, wow, you know, I've got this song and I want to present it, and how am I going to do that?
The songs have stood the test of time, and fortunately, Annie says releasing a greatest hits album doesn't spell retirement.
I will continue to make music, but I don't quite know exactly in which way yet, and I'm going to find out in the next few years.
The Annie Lennox collection is released on March the 9th, and she's 54. We've done the math. She's 54, so it's likely she'll be jumping out of planes at 90, I suppose. I've also done the math, and I can't afford Sir Ed's house, which is a shame. So you will need to buy it.